Hey guys, what's up? It is me. I am back. I haven't seen you guys in a little bit, about a week. Since I did my other short weigh-in video, it was very, very short. I'm so sorry because I'm just trying to fix like this camera. It's acting really goofy, but whatever. Okay, so basically we're gonna go over the weigh-in, how my week's been going, if it's been going good or if it's been going bad. I'm also gonna talk about some products that I purchased and some products that I plan on purchasing that I will be reviewing. And also my struggles with this week that passed, because I did have a couple, and just how my meal plan, if I plan on switching up anything yet, or if I plan on just sticking with what I'm doing. Okay, so let's do with the sticking with what I'm doing. Okay, basically, well, let's do the weigh-in first, because this is a weigh-in video. So, last week I weighed in at, hold on, I'm actually going to bring my fitness pal up on my phone. I changed my background, my phone to waffles. I've been craving waffles and pancakes lately. Zoom to me, why? Maybe because I see them on IG all the time. Okay, so last time I weighed in, it was at 279.6. So this week weighing in, I am at, blah, 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 I'm at 276.8. So that's a 2.8-pound loss. Now, with that, I'm happy, I'm cool, I felt like the fucking food scale really helped me, it really saved me, it really let me stay on track with my macros. It also, like, it just made me feel better. I was kind of weird about this week because I was like, hope I'm doing everything right, but apparently I am because I continue to walk like I always do. I didn't walk as much. One day I did do like an intense workout. For me, because it was intense on me, but I feel like I am getting stronger and I'm getting better at certain things, so it's a thumbs up for me. I'm happy with what the scale gave me this week. Last week it was 2 pounds, this week is 2.8, so about 2 pound average is cool, you know. I'm really hoping next week to actually lose 3, because I was so close to 3 this week. I'm really hoping next week to just lose 3. So I can just get up these 270s and get to them 260 so we can get back on track and just do what we need to do. But I feel good because we did have Easter, and actually on Easter, I went to a cookout. I didn't eat anything at the cookout. I kind of prepped everything before I went to the cookout with my family, my dad's side, me and my boyfriend. And I prepped everything before the cookout, so I was Gucci, and I ate. And I did take a protein bar, but I did not eat the protein bar while I was at the cookout. I did have 5 bicarbs, like in the 16-ounce bottle, and plus I had half a can of Mike's Hard 2, so that's probably like 8 fluid ounces. Well, it was half a 25, so it was more than 8 fluid ounces. I'd say about 15. Yeah, about 15 fluid ounces. It was 25 ounces, so it was about 15 fluid ounces. So with that, plus the fiber, because I was throwing them back to back, but remember, what I did that was smart was the fact that I wasn't eating, so I kind of felt like it mellowed it out, because since you're not eating and drinking, it kind of saved you from all the extra calories. So I was really worried about that. That's why I bust my ass. And I did do maybe one competitor, those little competitive challenges on my Fitbit. I did one this week, and I did a regular workout by Leslie Sampson. Next week, I really want to do 2 Leslie Sampson workouts, maybe hopefully another competitor, like, thing. But if I don't get a competitor thing, I will do 2 Leslie Sampson workouts, because I feel like those are pretty effective. They push me, they burn way more calories, and I've been sticking with my 1,500 calorie diet. But there are some days where, like, I've been known to eat, like, maybe before my weigh-in, this weigh-in previously, I think I ate 1,400. We want to check, because I don't want to tell you guys wrong information. Yeah, I ate about 1,485 yesterday. So, I ate about 14 yesterday, which is cool, because I wasn't super hungry most of the time. I mean, like, when I feel super hungry, like, I just take some chia seeds. Which I got in this bottle. I always have my chia seeds in this bottle. I'm actually glad I brought this back here. I sip on this and like around dinner time, and I really want to change my dinner time too. I want to talk to you guys about that. But I usually sip on this throughout the day, and it really helps me crave those. Am I hungry? Am I really hungry? You know? It really helps. And recently, I've also been doing the gallon of water, which is really useful. It's really helpful. It helps me stay in my water. Like right now, you can see I'm at like almost at 10 o'clock. I've been drinking a lot of water. Like, I love water. That's all I do. Really, I don't really drink anything else. And I also carry this around, this little water bottle, because I just like sip it out of that. But yeah, and I'm also waiting on my water bottles from AliExpress so I can do my detoxes, which will be helpful. Ugh, I can't talk today. Helpful. I also plan on getting some apple cider vinegar, which I'll be putting in one of those bottles to be my detox that I'll drink throughout the day to just help me stay where I need to be on my weight loss program. But I'll tell you about that more in detail in a minute. Yeah, but I've been doing the gallon of water 2 days. This is my second day doing it. I feel like it helps me. It helps me stay hydrated. I don't do it, like, in a certain time. Like, I have it set on here, like, sometimes on the bottle. We got 10. It starts at 8, and it goes all the way to 10. Because those are the hours I'm known to be awake and need to be drinking water. I need to eat at least a gallon a day, you know. So, I've been doing that recently. And what else have I been doing that's new? I'm sticking to my 1,500 calories because my doctor did tell me to stay with 1,500. I've seen some YouTube videos where people talk about, oh, well, they switched 13, 16. I just don't want to play with that because I don't want to send my body to starvation mode because I am still large. So I'm just going to stick with my 15 until I feel like it's time to change. I would probably say around 250. I need to 250. I'll probably change it to 14. Change it up and change up the exercise. But I feel like the walking 10,000 to 15,000 is good. I really want to stick to that all week. All week, I want to make sure I hit my 10,000 marker. I want to do my 2 Leslie Sampson workouts. And I've also been doing some resistance training. I definitely want to focus on that too because that really helps. I was really nervous at the cookout about the amount of alcohol I consumed. And the next day, child, I felt so sick, I felt so bloated, I felt so yuck. I was so disappointed in myself. I was like, why? It was just so horrible. I drank water and eventually, you know, I got cleansed. I actually did a detox that day. I think that really helped me too. Like get that bloating feeling. So I feel like maybe once a week I'll have a beer, but I'm just not gonna make a habit like to drink 5 or 6 like that again, because that was ridiculous. I actually have a 6-pack of Mike's Hard in my closet right now. My brother gave me, and I have one for Drew too. I just don't want to mess with it right now because it just sent me bad vibes on Easter. I feel like holidays and once a week is the only way. I probably, for my anniversary, which is next month, on the 2nd, I will have a beer with my boyfriend, but I'm trying to stray away from alcohol right now. But Easter went fantastical because I didn't overeat. I didn't really eat. I was just drinking, and I smoked a little bit, you know, and that was really it. Like, I didn't do too much, spend time with my family. There was fried fish there. I was actually 5 minutes away from eating some, but I didn't. I was really proud of myself. I actually left it on top of the car. I forgot about it. So, yeah, that's how that went down. I am happy to be down. I think I'm down even 10 pounds now. Which is great. I really have, I feel like I'm going to set some goals for me. Like, we'll say by my birthday, I would really like to be under 200. So, that means losing 76 pounds by my birthday. And we're in April, so May, June, July, August, September, October. So, really 6 months. I've never done something so crazy. I think, like, it took me 6 or 7 months to lose 80. But I don't know. I mean, if I push myself and I stick with it, I feel like it'll work for me. And I also got to put on my to-do list to get some more chia seeds because my chia seeds are getting low. But I'll probably purchase some chia seeds, probably at the beginning of the month. Chia seeds, Flavor God, I've been hearing about. I need to get on that. I'm going to get some Flavor God seasoning. I did pick up one seasoning today. I'm going to show you guys. And I just found, like, these great, like, skinless chicken. If you cut them while they're frozen and I made amazing stir fries this week. I made a great chicken thigh dish that I'm going to eat later on tonight. And I also made a gumbo with some turkey sausage and some veggies, and it was fantastical. So that's what's popping with that. I've been doing pretty good. I'm feeling pretty good. I haven't fell off the wagon yet, like, completely. So I just kind of feel like when you make a mistake, just get back up and keep going. Like, don't stop because you have 5 beers. Because I was, like, really upset about those 5 beers. Okay. So moving on. Yeah. I want to show you guys my screensaver, too. It is so pretty. Isn't those waffles so cute? It looks so delicious. I want some waffles. Actually, I'm still waiting for myself from AliExpress. I'm supposed to get my little waffle silicone thing to put in the oven. And I need to buy some oven cleaner because the oven needs to be clean. Okay, so now we're going to go into some things I purchased today. And some things I plan on purchasing soon that you guys should be on the lookout for because I placed some orders. I'm still waiting for all that stuff to come from AliExpress, but it's going to take time. Probably won't see that shit until like the end of May. And when it comes to the other stuff, you'll probably see it in a week or so. It shouldn't take that long. I'm going to order from eBay. And I'm going to order from, Thrive Market. I'm going to order from Thrive Market because I need some coconut. I can get the apple cider vinegar and the coconut oil. I would really like to get that today. That's what I want to tell you guys. I plan on ordering some more coconut oil because, let me show you why. Instead of tell you why, I should show you why. Here. I didn't purchase a lot from the stores go around. Look at my chia seed. It is getting super low. Like, I use this stuff every day. I have never used this stuff so much. But it is heart healthy. It supports cardiovascular. But yeah, I gotta work on that soon. We're gonna have a chia emergency. My coconut oil. Like, before I showed you guys, it was probably filled up to the top. I have been, like, going crazy with this stuff. And it smells so good. I've been going, like, ape shit with this. Right now, it's probably at this line right here. It's half. This was only a 12.9 ounce. It was, like, $6 or some change of Foodline. Foodline, way overpriced. Because on Thrive Market, they got it for low. Like, you get 15 ounce of this. But only $9. Only $9, but I love my coconut oil, my organic, unrefined coconut. Yeah, but with all the dramatics, yeah, and I think I still got a sweet potato that I'm gonna play with this week. Yes, I do. I still have a sweet potato left. I keep some of my stuff in my backpack because I just like to keep an eye on it so I can get an idea of what dishes I want to make. And stuff like that, but chia seeds is probably gonna be next on the list. But I do plan on ordering some protein pancakes, like a big box. It's gonna be like a 4.5 pound box of protein pancakes. I'm gonna order because I do want to try to at least eat protein pancakes every morning, like when I don't have certain things, like if I don't have the eggs or when I don't have, like, I don't want to eat oatmeal or I don't want to eat chicken or something like that. So I'm just gonna eat chicken in the morning just to get protein. I can eat protein pancakes and I can go about my day. I would only do it once a day because it's got 30 carbohydrates for 3 pancakes. And it's about 14 grams. It will bump up to 20 if you add milk and if you add eggs. But 14 grams is the minimum. And I would probably do it once a day. I wouldn't make a habit out of it. And as far as toppings, I probably would just use my peanut butter, which I love. Because I feel like peanut butter is sweet enough for me. I don't need a lot of sugar. I see some people on YouTube, they use Walden's Farm. That's cool too, but I'm not really into that sugar-free artificial taste. But I don't know, some people say it tastes really good, so I can't speak on that. I never had it, but I did purchase this. It's some coconut flakes. I just had this crazy idea. And with the protein pancakes I'm buying, you can really make protein brownies, you can make cupcakes, you can make cakes, you can even, I've seen people use it to make a pizza, like dough. Which is so cool because the protein will be out this world. But I just have an idea to like make some brownies and do some coconut flaked out like protein bars because I already got 14 grams of protein. And if you add regular protein to it, boom! What? So yeah, I definitely want to do some protein brownies, some protein cupcakes, some just protein everything. And this is a 14-ounce pound bag. It's got about, this bag has about, how many servings? 26 servings. I was going to get a smaller one that was 150, but I was like, this is too, like 190. I just look at this, because the other one was half the size. I would crush that, because I love coconut flakes. This has 4.5 fat, so it would be a treat topping. Sodium's decent. This is for 2 tablespoons and 7 carbs and 1 gram of, oh, something just popped up. Excuse me. And 0 grams of protein. It's really just like a treat. You don't really get anything from it, but it's a treat. It has a recipe on here for coconut macarons, which I could make, but make protein macarons. But I got some, oh, it's upside down. I got some coconut flakes. So I have to make some, I'm gonna make some crazy type of pancakes with this. Make some crazy cupcakes and protein. So I'm really excited to use this item that I purchased today. I didn't purchase a lot today. I did purchase a little packet of chicken meat, but I ate that with only a 90 calorie pack of chicken meat. I ate that with an orange today for my snack, because I do want to kind of incorporate snacks a little bit, because I don't really snack, and I need snacks sometimes. And then I also bought, I have a curry powder, but it's old. So I said I want some fresh curry powder, because I want to be able to change the color of my chicken. So I decided to pick up some of this. It's just a cheap brand of Spice Supreme. It is curry powder. And it can change the chicken a different color. I season my chicken with garlic and cilantro when I have it. But I already have like, I basically season it with, let me show you guys. So you guys can know how I season my food. I usually use the garlic seasoning, which is by the same company, because it's only a buck, and the Italian seasoning. 9 out of 10, that's what I'm using to season my food. But I have the curry powder to actually change the color of the chicken. It has 10 grams of sodium and 0 everything else. And this has nothing. I guess it's really nothing. Italian herbs, and it's not empty, it's still quite a bit in here. And then I have the garlic powder, which is 35 sodium, and I put this on everything. It's so great. And so I have all 3 of these. Next one will be onion powder. I just try to use natural herbs to season my food instead of salt. I don't use salt in my food. If it's already have salt in it, that's the salt I'll be eating. But I don't put extra salt, added salt in my food. That's just not something I do, because I suffer with high blood pressure. And I'm just going to keep all this stuff in my back pocket. And then I do make certain things. And like, different areas I keep my peanut butter, because I have like 3 jars of peanut butter in my closet. Regular peanut butter, not like a specialty brand peanut butter. And I keep one in with my measuring cup and my food scale. And it's the one that I use the most until it's all gone. And then I grab another jar. And I put it in the bag that I carry all my utensils for measuring. But I feel like the food scale has really been super helpful. So don't sleep on a good food scale. Like me and this other girl, her name is Sharice on Instagram. She lost a lot, but she lost like 70-some pounds. She's like, well, no, she lost. I don't know how she lost, but she's at like 65% on her fitness scale. Like that she's lost. So she's pretty close. And, like, we were just talking about different ways to season your food and just how useful food scales are. Because before, I was kind of upset that only 2 pounds, I worked out so hard, only 2 pounds I lost that week. But now with the food scale, I'm much happier because, you know, I've been measuring everything. I can literally eat 2 to 3 ounces. Like, I know I'm eating 2 to 3 ounces of cheese a day because I measure it and I track my macros. So, those are some new things that I purchased recently. Like I told you, the things I'll be purchasing from eBay, it's going to be the big 5-pound box of the baking, and basically it's called Kodak cakes. I've heard people talk about it, so I'm gonna place an order for that. And then I'm also going to be getting those fucking meal prep bowls. I don't care if it's the last thing I gotta do. I need those meal prep containers in my life, because it sucks using old Tupperware and you don't even have enough bowls and you gotta constantly wash dishes. And I'm really gonna push to get the coconut oil and the apple cider vinegar. But if I cannot get the coconut oil, I would damn sure get the apple cider vinegar because I need that. And if I gotta get the coconut oil Wednesday, I'll just get it Wednesday. But I need the apple cider vinegar in my life. So I'm gonna get that. I'm probably gonna end up putting the apple cider vinegar in here because I drink out my gallon jug for my water intake. But that's pretty much it right now. I don't plan on making another order until the 1st of May, which will probably most likely be, if I don't get the coconut oil this time, will be coconut oil. And I was going to get some Flavor Girl seasoning. I'll probably get one Flavor Girl seasoning. And maybe something else. I don't know what really else. I gotta look at my list to see what else I need, but I know for sure Flavor Girl seasoning. I'm gonna try to get the Tupperware today. So those are the things that are going on in my life. What's going on in yours? And weight loss is going good, and we're keeping the momentum. I've said we've been doing this for about 1, 2, 3. This is week 4 we're going in right now, actually. Yeah, because today's Sunday. This starts week 4, and this is the last weigh-in for April. So I'll probably next week is the last weigh-in. So next week when I do the video, this is the last weigh-in for April. So when I start the new weigh-ins for May, I'm going to title it New Weigh-ins for May. So you guys can stay updated and see what's going on with that. But I just wanted to show you a couple of items I purchased and how my meal prep is going, which is going fabulous. I've been really just stirring up some different ideas just to keep me interested in the shit. And I've been backing away from alcohol, which I really need to do. So that is pretty much it. I probably won't do another video until I get my new shit in the mail or Sunday. Most likely until I get my new shit because my new shit should be here sometime next week. So I'm going to leave that at 22 minutes. Don't want to make this too long. Hope you guys are having a great Sunday and keep on subscribing, liking, and commenting because I'm still here and we're still doing this and we're going to rock out. And any new ideas or any new things I hear about, I will damn sure do a video about it. So I need to drink my drink and get the rest of this. Ugh. I couldn't talk today. Get the rest of this water intake and then probably around 5 or 6 o'clock, I'm probably going to eat dinner because your girl will be getting hungry sometimes. So I'm going to leave it at that and I'm going to send off. And as always, we rock out with love, peace, and harmony because we all need that peace of mind. All need to love somebody, and we just need to harmonize for real. We just no, but for real, we all need to just be cohesive. You know what I'm feeling? So with that, I'm leaving, and I am going to place this order for the stuff, and so you guys can not wait too long for these protein pancakes on me. And I might do a video. I might use my tripod to do a video when I make the pancakes. I might do that just for you guys. I am outie.